He was known as the People's Mayor. Pittsburgh's Bob O'Connor, remembered after dying 5 years ago this fall from brain cancer, Michelle.
But tonight, only on 4, his widow tells us there is one last thing she wishes she could have done before he passed. One thing she's sharing with us and hoping you will take note.
During that time.
It was, it was hard. It really was.
Judy O'Connor remembers the difficult days by the side of her husband as he was dying. Looking back, there are regrets. Regrets of things that were never discussed.
Does he want that respirator, doesn't he? And I'd have his friends, I'd have more people in, and it would have been a lot easier for us.
Mrs. O'Connor is sharing her story and hopes you will have the discussion she and Mayor O'Connor never did. UPMC is holding a seminar with tips on how to prepare a living will to make sure your wishes are followed in your final days and to make things easier on your family.
What I see in my work is oftentimes no one's ever asked. There are families and loved ones and caregivers who really care about this person who's very sick, but feel very unable to make difficult decisions in the height of crisis because they've never asked.
Denise Voroski is the director of palliative care at Mercy. The plan focuses on 5 wishes: the person you want to make care decisions for you, the kind of medical treatment you want or do not want, how comfortable you want to be, how you want people to treat you, and what you want your loved ones to know. Judy said it was hard for her to make those decisions in the hospital because she only focused on Mayor O'Connor getting better.
I said, when you get out of here, we're going to have a parade. We're going to go. Everybody will be at that parade to welcome you back. And I really had hope, even till the end. Miracles happen. They really do. We weren't lucky enough to have that miracle happen.
If you'd like more information, we have a link on our website, WTAE.com, including links to great examples of living wills. You'll find it under As Seen on WTAE at the top of our homepage. And by the way, the UPMC event is tomorrow morning at Shadyside Hospital on Center Avenue from 9 until noon, and it is free.